What can you get out of studying Latin? Let's see if we can find out.
Infamy! Infamy! They've all got it in for me!
These Britons should be forced to learn Latin. Otherwise, it'll end up as a dead language.
Rubbish.
Salve.
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 Salve. Salve.
Here, every child, no matter what their special education need, they all learn Latin to begin with. There are so many vignettes at Brookmead where scholars with really fundamental complexities in their background have really taken to Latin.
I think Latin really lends itself to a certain kind of logical thinking that students find very reassuring. Adults, when you speak to them, often say, oh, I didn't like learning Latin. The grammar was really dull.
The Romans did all this with a language that we know from school is silly. It's a silly, billy language.
And yet, when we ask the students, what do you like? They often say, oh, I find it quite easy.
It's an easy language to learn.
Which is such a funny thing to say about a really complex language. But we mustn't underestimate the power of feeling really good at something.
I really enjoy, like, being able to translate from Latin into English and making those correlations between the languages.
Romance languages branch directly off Latin, such as Italian, Spanish and French, and it can help you learn those languages.
I think this is levelling up in action. I think this is what it looks like. We take scholars who come from extremely deprived backgrounds and we teach them Latin once a week. And when you are in the classroom, you cannot tell which scholars come from which backgrounds. They are all enthusiastic. They are all delighted to be given this chance to learn what is traditionally seen as a very scholarly language.
Our children deserve it. Why should it only be the preserve of the wealthy and a small elite? It's a matter of social justice.
We saw an advert from Classics for All about an opportunity for inner city schools to teach Latin. It just sounded exceptionally exciting and we definitely wanted to get involved. So we contacted Hilary straight away and said, what do we do next? Where do we sign?
And I'll kind of get this, you teach Latin to inner Birmingham City School children? Because of course the stereotypes are there. Why are we teaching them such an old language? And again, it comes back to that root of vocabulary. It helps us across the curriculum. The children love it. They absolutely adore it. You say we're doing Latin and they're on the edge of their seats.
I like it because it's the etymology of words and it helps to speak new languages.
The children just, when they see something they recognise, it's just a buzz in the classroom that you can't explain. It's just over to them, really.
Amore! Lovely!
So around 18 months ago, we were invited, shall we say, by our head teacher that we would be introducing Latin to the school for the first time. Myself and Sophie were given 12 hours worth of training.
A lady came in from Classics for All and looked at Latin all around us to kind of let us know that we knew more than we thought we did. And I think that was a real light bulb moment where we looked at each other and thought, actually, yeah, we can do this.
I feel really lucky because, like, not a lot of people would get the opportunity.
It's an exciting language to learn.
It is really fun.
Without that funding, without that grant to begin with, we'd be nowhere near where we are now with it.
People ask me, what do you do for your A-levels? And I say, oh, I do classic civilization. It's immediate, what on earth is that? And then I go on to explain, you know, it's a bit of history, the Romans, the Greeks, a bit of literature, and immediately a lot of people are like, wow, that sounds really interesting. I never got the opportunity to do that.
I think classics is really, really important for giving students confidence.
and then they're not thrown, you know, if a politician is spouting a bit of Greek or making a reference to a, you know, a mythical battle or something like that. Often people do use it as a way to sort of try to suggest they are more intelligent than someone else. And actually what it is, it's not an intelligence thing, it's an opportunities thing.
I think classics enables you to be a very well-rounded individual.
If more people are aware of kind of political propaganda in the ancient world, they'll be able to recognise it in everyday, so more people would kind of be aware of what the politicians are trying to spin, which I think is a really valuable skill.
As a former student here, I went off to university and did ancient history, and you can really see, again, there's a number of students who are wanting to fulfil their ambitions to study classics or ancient history at university, which is brilliant to see.
It's been a fantastic addition to our suite of A-level courses here at Greenhead.
Without the funding and the continuation of it, that will stop, and we'll lose a whole generation of maybe easy wins, if you like.
Having someone like Classics for All to help is going to be vital in encouraging people to push for it in new centres in the future.
Gratias tibi ago.